Hello everyone, it's me, Sam, again for another Tide Pool Tuesday. It's very calm, so there's not so many waves to look out for, but whenever you're on the beach, again, please just face forward the waves, especially if you're close to the water, just in case one comes up and sweeps you off your feet. And also watch out for the slippery seaweeds on the rocks. I have some pretty good footwear on right now, so I don't slip and fall. So just all these safety things to keep in mind before we explore on your beach. Now the tide today isn't quite as low as last time we were here, but we can still see some pretty cool tide pools. So let's go ahead and see what we can see. Here's one of the tide pools that we were looking at last time in the middle zone. So just at a quick inspection now, I can see that green filamentous algae we were looking at last time, the Enteromorpha, there doesn't seem to be quite as much as there was last time, and it's not as long either. I suspect it's because the periwinkles have been having a really good munch on this, especially now as it's heading into the warmer summer season. My goodness. This guy somehow is out of the water. This looks to be a snailfish. He's a snailfish. Oh, there he goes. Case in point about safety. I actually slipped on this darker green stuff. This is right here. So if you're hiking among the rocks, just watch out for anywhere that's darker like this. This can be very, very slick. So in this little tide pool, we have a sea anemone. Confirm what species of sea anemones these are. And I suspect these are gem anemones or silver spotted anemones. They'll often cover themselves in some sand or gravel to help hide themselves in the tide pools. There he goes. How beautiful is that? Oh! So it looks like, oh, there's actually two there. Cool. So those things that are waving around, those long string-like things, those are the sea anemone's tentacles. So they have a ring of tentacles that's surrounding their mouth. So they're waving the tentacles right now. They're looking to catch some food, like little beach hoppers or little tiny animals. So once they catch their food, they will transfer it into, So they'll transfer it into their mouth, which is in the middle there. They can only eat one object of food at a time. So once they have their mouth full, they'll have that digested and then they can eat again. So look at that tidal action. Pretty neat. On a calm day like today especially, that's just a wave coming in there, but you can really appreciate how the water levels are falling from the rocks here. So out on the water today, last week we had a seal, this week it looks like we have a loon. So on the water here you could see it's like a clear, almost like a clear little shrimp. So what we're looking at here is the molt, or another word that starts with the E that I had difficult pronouncing, so I'll probably edit it as a word into this video. So many crustaceans, like these little beach hoppers and shrimps, as they grow, they will molt their old shell. So they grow on the inside, the shell is too hard, so they actually have to take off the shell in order to grow or molt. So this is what is here right now. It's a molt of a beach hopper. Oh man, so I just missed it. Oh, there he goes. So right there, that is a sea anemone that is eating a poor little gammarid. So, this was the anemone that just ate that gammarid. See how he's all coiled up now? So that anemone would have stung
the gammarid with his stingy cells in his tentacles. It's nematocyst. And it is consuming it.
Well, it looks to be that time again. We're getting close to that time when the tide is going to turn and go from high tide to... No. The tide's going to turn and go from low tide to high tide. Yes. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Saw some cool little things again today. And as always, if you decide to go out on the beach, take lots of pictures, but please leave the seaweed and animals where they are. And most of all, be safe, have fun, all that good stuff. Till next time.